I will try to explain the market surplus, excess supply and excess demand and the equilibrium. So you can see that it price 5th, we start from here, that it price 10. The quantity demanded is 1000, which is just shown here, because this line is the demand line and this one is the supply line. But the supply quantity supplied is only 200. It means when it between 1000 and 200, the difference of 8 means 800. So there is excess demand. More people wanted to buy as compared to the availability of the goods or services. It means we have the shortage or excess demand. Then when price rises from 10 to 20, then demand decreases from 1000 to 800, because the law suggests that whenever price rise, people buy less, but the quantity supplied increases. This is also suggested by the law that whenever price increase, supply also increase. So when price rise from 5 to from 10 to 20, then quantity demanded becomes 800 and quantity supplied become 400. Then we have such kind of the difference. So again, we have the excess demand. Then again, when price rises, then we have the, it suppose 15 price, the quantity demanded is 600 and the price quantity supplied is also the 600. So this is the point where market is in the equilibrium. And when price is above this 15 price, which is treated as or known as the market equilibrium price, and this one is known as the market equilibrium quantity. That when price is above the equilibrium price, then we have this 400 of the quantity demanded and 800 of the quantity supplied. It means people want to sell 800 units, but buyers, they are only willing to buy 400 units. So there is excess supply or surplus. Then again, if price is above 20 to 25, then quantities demanded will then come back or will decrease. So now the quantity demanded is 200, but at the higher price, the quantity supplied is 1000. So the excess, there will be excess supply. 800 units are in excess quantity. Means people only want to buy 200 items at 25, but the sellers, they are willing to sell 1000 units. So it will create the excess supply or surplus in the market. Excess supply or excess of demand. What is the excess of demand? It is a situation when market price is lower than the equilibrium price, or demand is greater than the supply. When price is below the equilibrium price, then it creates the excess demand, means it can encourage the people to buy more. So we can also say that demand is greater than the supply. Buyers will not be able to buy what they want to buy. Market price is pushed up, which leads to two consequences. It means whenever there is a market excess of demand or shortage in the market, the buyers, they are unable to buy whatever they wanted to buy, and it pushed the prices to rise, and it creates two consequences. It has two consequences. Number one, supply increases as producers are willing to supply more at a higher price. Means when excess demand push the prices to rise, it encourages the sellers to sell more. And it, when prices rise, it discourages the buyers to buy more, so demand decreases. As buyers will buy less at a higher price, this tendency of increase in supply and decrease in demand will continue until equilibrium is established. So we can, now we explain the excess of supply, or we can say the surplus. It is a situation when market price is higher than the equilibrium price. Means in graph or in table, when the price is up higher than the equilibrium price, If we say suppose previously 10 was the equilibrium price, but now 11, it means it's higher than the previous one. So whenever there is a higher price than the equilibrium price, then demand will be less than the supply. So sellers will not be able to sell what they want to sell. Market price is pushed down, which leads to two consequences. Means when more people willing to sell but few people they are willing to buy, it creates the two consequences. Supply decreases, these producers are willing to supply less at a lower price. Demand increases, it buyers will buy more at a lower price. This tendency of decrease in supply and increase in demand will continue until equilibrium.